Hey everyone, I'm Howard Pinsky, and in this Adobe XD video, we're going to take a look at creating a fun weather icon with a hint of a background blur. Let's get to it. Here I am in Adobe XD with a widget I've been designing, and I'd love to include a playful icon at the top right corner to better illustrate the current weather conditions. Let's start off by creating the cloud. With the ellipse tool, draw out the first shape, holding down Shift to constrain it to a perfect circle. Next, to add more volume to our cloud, additional shapes can be placed on either side, making sure they align with the bottom of the largest. This can be done by either drawing out an entirely new ellipse, or duplicating and resizing the existing. You'll want these to vary in size to add a bit of randomness to the cloud. With these in place, you may find that there are small gaps between the shapes. So, to help cover this up, a rectangle can be added, starting and ending at the horizontal centers. Perfect. With the gaps now covered up, we'll want to combine these shapes into a single object. So, selecting them all either on canvas or within your layers panel, you can add them to a Boolean object at the top right of the properties inspector. We can now proceed with styling, which will apply to our combined shape. Starting off with the fill, we're going to add a subtle radial gradient, with the center color set to a pure white, and the outer color set to a very light blue to help us add a touch of shading and depth to our cloud. But we likely don't want the highlight in the center, so expanding the radius and shifting the gradient towards the top of the layer will achieve a more natural look. Next up, let's add a subtle inner shadow to act as an additional highlight. 100% white with the values somewhere around 1, 2, and 14 should leave us with a nice soft glow. And even though part of the gradient is white, the larger blur will let the inner shadow hit the shaded areas as well. Moving on to my second favorite type of shadow, a drop shadow. This will also be on the subtle side to pull the cloud up from the widget's background. And by bumping up the Y and blur values, you should be left with a shadow that's there, but also not there. I'm also a big fan of bringing in a bit of the background color to my shadows. So in this case, I'll go with a medium to dark blue, and then experiment with the opacity. Again, making sure it's nice and subtle. Perfect. The final style we're going to tack on is the background blur, which may not look that exciting when you first activate it, but adjusting the values below will certainly help dial in the look that you're after. For this element, keeping the blur amount on the lower end will allow us to make out the objects behind the cloud. And bumping up the effect opacity will bring back the gradient and shadow we added a few moments ago. This blur, of course, is completely optional, and the cloud looks pretty good even without it, but it will look even better with more elements behind it. Let's add a sun. With another ellipse, a circle can be drawn out. Then for the styling, we'll stick to a solid color, somewhere in the bright orange range, since vibrant tones interact well with background blurs. Similar to the cloud, we can also apply an inner shadow to add a glow or highlight to the top of the sun. The color of the shadow should be slightly more yellow than the base shape. Then bumping the values, including the blur, will leave our sun looking quite striking. But it could use some sun rays as well. Duplicating this existing shape, I'm going to enlarge it a touch, and then remove the existing styles so that we can apply just a border on either the inside or outside of the shape. The size can be adjusted to set the thickness of the rays. Then the gap can also be increased to space them out. But where are they? With the caps currently set to but, you won't be able to see the border without a dash. But switching the caps over to round will leave us with nice circular rays. Of course, you can certainly add in a dash if you want to elongate your borders. With the sun now looking great, I'll quickly group these two elements, then make sure they're placed behind our cloud, where we should be able to see that some of it is now nicely blurred. To wrap up this design, let's add a few final touches. Our cloud is looking pretty decent, but I'm thinking some additional depth may help really make it pop. With one more ellipse, I'm going to draw one out over top of the cloud's left-hand circle, making sure it's approximately the same size. You can also copy the layer from within the Boolean object and paste it outside. Next, I'm going to set the blend mode to soft light and the color to a neutral gray. This will allow the shape to perfectly blend with the cloud behind it, while also allowing the styles, like a drop shadow, to come through. Here, we're only going to want this to graze the top, so pushing the X and Y values into the negatives and increasing the blur slightly should leave us with a nice result. Then, if you're looking for more, a light inner shadow can also be applied. This time, we'll want it focused on the left and top of this shape. and to give it an extra fluffy feel, the values could be set a bit higher than the drop shadow. Wonderful. The final element we're going to add is rain. Right below the cloud, I'll draw out a line with the line tool. Then within the properties inspector, the size can be increased to thicken it up, and the caps can be rounded out to match the rest of our design. Since we're after a rainy look, we can now experiment with the dashes and gaps to separate the line a touch. And for this one, one short and one long segment could work. This line can then be duplicated over to create the second, and to mix it up, it can not only be extended, but the dash and gap values can be tweaked to add some variance. Finally, one more over to the right, and to keep this simple, I'll bring the line back up a touch. With the rain now in place, I'll quickly group all three lines, then either rotate or shift the bottom points over to the left to give the impression that it's also windy. Finally, the blend mode can be set to soft light so that they subtly fade into the widget's background. And just like that, you've created a weather icon with a fun blurred cloud. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe for more content. Follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you all next time.